Because if you turn clockwise, you're going to wind up where you started.
All right.
I want you to turn counterclockwise. Because as you're turning counterclockwise, go ahead. God said, what the enemy meant for evil, I just turned it around for your good. He said, what the enemy meant for your evil, I just turned it around for your good. And you'll see the manifestation of the third not many days hence. But the mouth of the Lord spoke. I wish somebody would have a praise.
Thank you.
something that most would not do. The comparison between Hannah and Sarah was Sarah laughed, Hannah prayed. Sarah laughed concerning her circumstance. Hannah prayed regarding her circumstance. Some of you have to realize and understand that some situations are not a laughing matter. If God wants to speak through you and to you through a situation that is critical even unto death. Hannah thought that if I could even just utter a release of prayer out of my mouth, that God would respond. As I shift this mic over, as we open up to do prayer, is that fine? Amen. I will shift this mic over to Elder Tate to call in this time of altar call. That coming up to the altar, do not, and I repeat, what we have learned over the years, Bishop, and what they taught us even back in our younger days, that we didn't come to the altar to receive prophetic declaration. We came to the altar because there was a sacrifice that needed to be wrought so that we are stripped of our inconsistencies. Tonight, remember, as we're concluding in this passage, in this phrase, in this celebration, that any day now, God says, many of you have been at the brink of a breakthrough, but something has held it up. So tonight, as I release this mic to Elder Tate to call the altar call, examine your hearts, examine your minds. In this story of Hannah, Hannah went beyond and ignored the continued provoking until Jesus responded and she got her answer. So I say, Pastor Woodall, your answer is your divine reward for consistency and being committed. When others walked away, and when others said that the doors were shut to Yahweh, that God was still manifest through your time of prayer. Clap your hands and give God praise on this day.
If you're in the sanctuary tonight, you've been waiting on an answer. You've been waiting for God to move on your behalf. You understand that it's any day now, but right now you're just a tad bit weak. You can almost believe it, but you can't get it right just yet. If you need prayer for any reason, the altar is open for you. Won't you come? There could be somebody here tonight that's not saved. Somebody that's in need of deliverance. Somebody that just needs prayer. The altar is open. Won't you come? Won't you come? Won't you come? Come and do like Hannah did. Pour your heart out before the Lord. We don't have to know what you're talking to him about. Just talk to him. Because he's the one that can fix it. Come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on. Whatever your petition, whatever your request, come on and just pour it out to him now. 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 Somebody else needs to come. Somebody else needs to come. Thank you. they stand their feet up, from the top of their head to the soles of their feet. Give it to them now.
Healing your shadow, yes, God. Heal now, God. Allow your soul.
the Lord is still in this place. And we bless him. We thank him for his presence. For in the presence of the Lord, there is fullness of joy. And at his right hand, there are pleasures evermore. In Jesus' name, all of God's people say, amen. Amen. Won't you hug somebody and let them know any day now, God's going to do it for you.